Yes, okay, let me start off by saying I'm so embarrassed. I'm so freaking embarrassed because where the hell have I been? Yeah, I know where I have been, but like I can't come on here and tell you guys I'm gonna be consistent, I'm gonna bring you guys content, whatever, and then I disappear for 2 whole months. But anyway, did I even greet you guys? To my channel. For those of you that are new here, my name is Bill, and if you're a returning subscriber, I'm missing that so much. Thank you so much for returning. And guys, we genuinely need to find an intro for this channel. And before I start this video, I just want to thank you guys so much for engaging with my last video. Like, that was so good. Like, you guys are making me shy. You guys are making me shy or whatever. Like you guys. You guys did that. Anyway, let me not ramble. Let me get into today's video. So, for those of you that do not know, I just finished my first year, hopefully. I just finished my first year of Varsity. So, yeah, that's been wild. That's really been wild. So, I just decided, you know what? Let me just film a video about the things that I learned or I wish I knew. Things I learned or things that I wish I knew before going to varsities. So I'm hoping this video is going to be helpful to people that are going to be doing their first year. So let's get straight into the background information about the course that I'm doing. So I am in Botswana Accountancy College and I am doing International Finance and Banking. And It is an honors. Oh, it's 4 years long and it is. Clearly, I can avoid saying it, so I must learn how to say it. It is an honors degree. I think so. So it is 4 years and it is. Okay, so basically what BAC, I don't even know if this information is necessary, but I'm just going to give it to you guys because I like talking. So if you see me looking down, I wrote these down because I couldn't type them on my phone because I use my phone to film. Anyway, it is, so what basically happens is that BAC works with universities that are outside the country. Like, the courses that you do are going to be accredited for by universities that are outside the country. So the course I'm doing is accredited for by Sheffield Hallam University. Okay, so that was just background information on the course that I'm doing. And guys, I urge you to do your research before you pick your course because okay, if you want to know anything else, if you have any further questions and you're going to do the same course that I'm doing, you're free to DM me on Instagram. My Instagram details are in my description below. And also, please make sure to follow me. So I'm going to now go into things that I learned and things that I wish I knew before going to varsity and what I learned after going to varsity. The first thing I'm going to talk about is friends. Guys, you are not going to be friends with the people you were friends with in varsity, in high school. 95% of the people you're friends with in high school are not going to be your friends. You're not going to talk. You're not going to interact on any level. I mean, your closest of your closest of your closest friends in high school. Chances are you're not going to interact. And that's completely okay because we're different. We grow. I mean, this is a different stage in our lives, not high school. We're growing. We're finding different interests. We're probably in different varsities. And that's fine. Like, you're not going to be friends with the people you're friends with in high school. Even if right now, before varsity, you guys are still talking, you are not going to be friends. Also, always remember that the people that you surround yourself with are a great representation of self-love. Like, make new friends. Find people that have similar interests as you. Do things, hang out with people that benefit to your personal growth as an individual. Like, they should benefit to you growing as an individual rather than taking away from you. Also on friends, you need to make friends with people in your course. Okay, not really friends, but make acquaintances with people that are in your course. Because you guys are gonna need each other. Like, you guys are gonna need to work together and actually get that degree, those degrees together, because that place, like, you can't be a loner and expect, you will get your degree, but it's going to be difficult. The thing is that when you get to varsity, You are going to meet people from... Guys, I spent my whole life in one school. I went to Varsity and I met... Like, there's people that went from, yeah, okay, fine, in primary, go JMS, okay, and then in high school, I went to school in Mopato, or there's people that were like, yeah, Niketanaka, and then I went to school there. And I spent my whole life in one school. Literally, I didn't know people outside the people that I went to school with. So when I went to Varsity, I met people from different walks of life. Literally, the whole country. And you can't come with the mentality that you're going to be friends with people that you went to school with. There's about four of us that are in BAC that went to the same school. Four. And the hostel that I was staying in, majority of those people were from the same place. Now imagine I'm coming from one place and I'm meeting different people from different walks of life. So that's completely different. You need to be accommodative of people's different characters. That was very difficult for me in the beginning because I was like, why are you that thing? But I had to learn to understand that I'm not gonna meet the same people that I was with initially, and I'm gonna meet people from different walks of life, and I need to be accommodative. I need to familiarize myself with those people. I need to make acquaintances with those people. I need to get along with those people. So you are going to need to get out of your shell and get along with people from different walks of life. And be accommodative of the way they think, of their understanding, of their beliefs. Because just because you believe in one thing doesn't mean that they believe in that same thing. The third thing that I'm going to talk about is feeling lost. I don't really relate to this because the school that I go to is quite small and we had orientation. So you basically knew where what was. You basically know where what is. And as much as they're different campuses, you know that if you're in a certain school, you're going to a different campus. If you're in a certain school, you're going to a different campus and stuff like that. So I can't really relate with this whole thing of getting lost. But for my friends that were schooling in different universities, someone was like, they went to attend a different they didn't know, because their school was so big, they didn't know where what was, to a point where they had to attend a lecture that was not even theirs and they didn't even know what was happening, and it was for people in upper years or whatever. So prepare yourself for that. You need to be able to ask around. I guarantee you that you're not the only one that's feeling lost. The reason why you need to make friends with people in your course is that you need to be able to ask them, where are we going? Like, if you're getting lost, you must get lost together. Okay, I'm lying. But you guys must, you know, help each other navigate school, navigate everything that's happening in Varsity. Because boy, I tell you, I kid you not, it's hell. This thing that I'm about to talk about is very hypocritical of me to say, because God knows I don't even do this. You guys, you need to attend all your lessons. You see, the lesson that you don't feel like going for the most, that one particular lesson that you don't feel like going for, that's the lesson that you should attend. That's the lesson that you should get up in the morning and go to. Like, literally, there's literally nothing that's going to benefit you from staying in and sleeping. Guys, take it from me. Literally, reza kanadog. When I tell you, hey, guys, okay, not necessary. Let me not paint myself as a bad child. Guys, I attended for my mother and my father, if they're watching this video, I attended my lessons. But for those of you guys that are my mother and my father, I skipped lessons, okay? There were times when I'd skip lessons and I'd just be like, I'm tired. And I just can't go for my lesson because it's so fucking early and I don't want to go for my lesson. Oh, also, we had a problem of hot water. So any opportunity, okay, not really any opportunity, but like the water would come in the afternoon and not in the morning. So you'd have to bath at like 1, 2 p.m. because if you bath in the morning, you're gonna have to bike it. So I'd be like, never think I eat up, I'll bike it. They'd be like, it last thing. Or the night before would have been studying, but, and then would go to bed at like 3. And then in the morning at 6, you have to wake up and bath and go to school. And I'd be like, never think I'll be like, never think mama demo. I give a thought last thing, go to class. Like, I remember I missed one lesson that was so important because the teacher was giving examination tips. Not even examination tips. You know when the teacher gives you like areas to focus on when studying? I missed that lesson. Because Nekorowitz, guess where that got me? Studying the whole night before the actual exam, because brings me to my next point. FD is a real thing. Like, FD is a real thing. I remember even recently, like, I'm sure this was a mistake, but, like, to show you that FD is a real thing, people failed and they didn't even get a chance to, like, what's it called? They didn't even get a chance to redeem themselves. Let me use that word. To redeem themselves. And they were instantly given an FD. It happens. And you can't even judge someone for FD because it's hell in there. Like, you really have to know why you are there, why you are in school, and what you're doing in school. You must be there for each other there by Varsity.
And then now this becomes my 6-point groove.
Okay, you can't go for groove every single time. Like, you genuinely cannot go to groove every single time. It's okay if you miss. Like, you don't have to be at every single event. It's okay for you to miss out on something. But other than that, everything is your choice in Varsity. Like, I can't control what you do or what you think or what you say or what you want to do with your life. If you decide you're going for groove and you have an exam the next morning, that's your personal choice and that's okay. But you really need to remember why you're there. You also need to know your type of fun. Like, just because Peter is going for Kamsa and you know Horwena, big crowds make you anxious, don't go. Like, don't be forced to go because Peter's not gonna be of, nobody cares about that thing in high school. I mean, in Varsity, this is not high school anymore. Peter's not gonna stop being your friend because you can't go for Kamsa, okay? So you need to know the type of fun that you wanna have and stick to that. Like, you need to know you. This is a place where you just discover yourself, you just know yourself, you just know who you are. Guys, you have to save your allowance. Like, you think someone that's doing finance is going to be like, yeah, I have a budget. I feel so guilty for saying this, Ibile. Like, I feel so bad. Like, I feel so irresponsible. But you think you have a budget. Okay, fine. Hey, in the first month, book allowance plus living allowance or water. Wow, I am going to paint. You're in English. Paint the town red. I'm going to spoil myself. I'm going to do this. Do best, do that. But at the end of the day, you must know who you are coming back to eat noodles. Like, wahujadi noodles, uncle. But anyway, Durban curry is the best flavor there is out there. Save your allowance. Literally live within your means. Like, I used to hate it when my mom used to tell me, you need to live within your means. Okay, she doesn't talk like that. She'll probably be so mad. She doesn't, you need to live within your means. You can't be wanting to live a flashy lifestyle yet you don't have the money to do so. So you need to save your allowance. I'm not saying don't spoil yourself. No, spoil yourself. But you should think about tomorrow, because 1/27 and the next 27th, the next point is, if you're living on campus, make use of catering ladies. Batung, how go gaja? Unless, of course, on LMIT. How gaja KFC every day though? Like, how gaja KFC every single day? KFC, like. But make use of catering ladies. It's better to eat one full meal, to eat cereal in the morning and then noodles and then a full meal at dinner. Because now if you eat cereal in the morning and then you eat noodle and then you eat bread, it's like, there's nothing wrong with that. I mean, I live like that. I survive. Look at me now. I survive. But make use of catering ladies. It's literally 300 pula to 350 pula per month to eat. I mean, some of them really do cook nonsense. I got really mad. But like, make use of catering ladies. Literally, that will save your life. You will not. My next point is, make good relations with people. Like, you can't be mean to people, not in Varsity. That's not how, like, so make good relations, especially people that are doing your course and people that are in, I said this before, people that are in upper grades of your course, because you're gonna need them, ne? How got that degree one? I mean, at the end of the day, it's your degree, but you kind of need to work with people to get your degree. And then the next thing is, get rid of high school mentality. We're not in high school anymore. That phase is over. Yeah, you're gonna feel really dumb when you get to Varsity. It doesn't matter whether you were an A-star student in high school or you were an average student in high school. Varsity will show you that. Even like that average student in high school, you'll see that average student in high school doing better than you who was an A-star student in high school. Like, they... Get rid of high school mentality. Like, you are not, this is not a,
there's no competition. Like, there is really no competition. Bo, hey, now I'm not going to help you because I'm top 10. I'm going to top 10 at university. There's nothing like that. Work with people. There's group discussions that are a real thing. You're going to need to work with people. You can't come and be like, yeah, I get, like, it's very difficult to build communication skills or have group discussions with people and all of that stuff. But you're not going to get through your coursework alone. I'm saying coursework because that's just a mere example. But you're not going to get through your coursework alone. And majority of the time, you're going to find that in the module that you're doing, group work. So you need to get rid of that high school. These tips that I've given you guys are helpful and they're going to be beneficial to you. It's a nice place to be. It's nice, but it's like very, you lose yourself. You need to know who you are. You need to know why you're in varsity. You're going to lose friends. You're going to get your heart broken. You're going to lose friends. You're going to get your heart broken. But at the end of the day, you're going to make it out. This video wasn't too long. If you've come this far in the video, thank you so much for watching. Please make sure to like, comment, share, subscribe, ask questions that you wanna ask. Share this video with your friends. Share this video with people that need it. Also, guys, my birthday is coming up. So now I'm gonna ask you guys of one favor as a birthday gift. If you have already subscribed, share the link with your friends so that your friends convince them to subscribe. And if you haven't subscribed, if you're just watching, that button, yay, ready, yo. Okay, your name.